Welcome to my new Patreon video. This time I want to talk a little bit about the Basket Hilted Dagger. Basket Hilted Dagger is a parry dagger which is known by various names and designs. Sometimes called an alehouse dagger or lowland dagger, reaver dagger or just basket dagger. But we should not confuse all these terms and keep in mind a very specific difference between the two major dagger designs, or better said, their hilt designs. The name alehouse dagger became quite popular in the HEMA community since the excellent article by Paul Wagner on this topic. I will post a link to this article in the video description below, so there you can find a lot of information and source quotes. Generally speaking, when we use the term alehouse dagger, we can think of the 16th and 17th century parry dagger, often used with a backsword. But we also know from sources like Joseph Swetnam that the English seem to have preferred close-tilted parry daggers as a companion for the rapier too. The obvious purpose of the half-basket or full-basket hilt is to protect the dagger hand, especially against cuts, so you can quite direct parry against them to stop the blow. It is also known that these daggers, which could have the dimensions of short swords even, were useful in crowded places, like a pub or an alehouse, hence the name. So in a pub brawl, this would come very handy to not only attack, but especially to defend against longer impact weapons like cudgels or like swords and the like. But still, it would be short and agile enough to be used effective in close quarters. As you can see on these pictures, this design had its protection mostly on one side of the dagger, so similar to rapier daggers as we know them from Spain and Italy. The blade is long, double-edged, very pointy, and looks quite robust, as we can see on these historical examples. The crossguard is sometimes straight, but very often is bending upwards with its ends. This makes it more comfortable to be worn on a belt, but it also helps to bind the blade of the opponent better, especially against thrusts. Sometimes this weapon is also called a reaver dagger, as it was popular amongst the border reavers, so the famous riding raiders in the borderlands of northern England and the Scottish lowland. Therefore, it is sometimes referred also as a lowland dagger. In historical fencing manuals, we can see, for example, that George Silver promoted the dagger as a good offhand tool with a sword, both with good protective hilts, even though the dagger in the picture by Silver does not really look like it. The same is true when we look at the English edition of de Grassi's manual on using the early rapier or side sword. The swords and daggers shown here have closed hilts and, as it seems, to have been the preferred fashion in 16th century England. And the same is true for Swetnam's English rapier. The fencers in the company of Meisters would also use daggers together with a backsword in their prize fights. So the basket hilt dagger in its earlier fashion, or like a reaver or alehouse dagger, is very close connected to 16th century English history. In the 18th century, the daggers were used again in companion with a backsword in the so-called prize fights of the stage gladiators. But according to the pictures of James Miller, we can see that these were daggers with full basket hilts, so just like the backsword or broadsword had. They offer much more hand protection, but are not too practical to be carried around on a belt all day. So my assumption is that these daggers were mostly connected with the organized prize fights on the stage and maybe a nod into the destination of the pass to the prize place of the company, just like the buckler. Because we know of no military or civilian use outside of the stage gladiator context. I have a very nice example here made by Windlass Steelcraft, based on different originals. It was very inexpensive and a coincidental find online, so I just ordered two of them, so I have one sharp and pointy, and the other I made blunt and safe for training purposes. And they are robust enough for sparring with small sword, but also with back swords. For the price, these daggers are quite nice, I have to say, but there are way more better makers out there who make alehouse and full basket hilt daggers. Like in example, Balefire Blades, the sword maker Chris Adams, who made our Angelo training broadswords. But I also saw alehouse daggers made by Todd Cutler, Armor Class, and Castile. So you can have both full basket hilt daggers, but also the older style of the alehouse dagger with a half basket. The biggest difference between the earlier form of the alehouse daggers or with more kind of a half basket on the side is obviously how you grip it, so compared to the full basket hilt. So the alehouse dagger I grip more like a rapier parry dagger, so with the thumb of my left hand, if I'm a right-handed fencer and I have the dagger in my left hand, I use the thumb on the side of the grip, so on the flat of the blade, and so I have the bars, the iron bars or the basket, more on the front over my knuckles and over my fingers. So this way I can easily parry thrusts, just like with a rapier dagger, parry dagger, but I also have enough protection to parry a cut to my head. With a full basket, I just grip it like a sword. So with a full, sometimes called handshake or hammer grip, whatever you prefer in the terminology. But I have a full basket, so my hand is protected all around. So if you ask me which one is better for combat, obviously the full basket hilt is much better, I have to say. With the half basket, you can parry thrusts a little bit, you know, more nimble, with a little bit more feeling in your hand, a little bit more control in the bind. But against cuts, the full basket hilt is much better because you can directly parry with your dagger an incoming blow. It's strong enough, so you don't have to fear that your dagger is hit out of your hand or that the cut goes through. So you are well, very, very safe. However, as I mentioned before, in a civilian context, to carry around the full basket hilt dagger is a little bit uncomfortable. So here the alehouse dagger in close quarter combat is much better, and also when you have to carry it around on your hip all day. If you want to train with the alehouse or basket hilt dagger, you can get an affordable synthetic one made by Black Fencer, which you see here in this video. Just send them a message that you want one, because it is not listed in the shop. Some 18th century manuals mention the dagger briefly, like I said, Donald McBain, James Miller and Archibald MacGregor. From this little material and in connection with our practical experiences, we created an ongoing lesson series on the use of the basket hilt dagger together with a backsword. So if you don't know these, check them out.